Hello, Herman here with a new video in the ClearPass workshop series where we will build a ClearPass deployment from scratch and integrate with wired, wireless, Active Directory and much more. In this video, we will be building our ClearPass cluster. In the last video, we installed the HPE certificate, so we have a publisher available now. The first appliance in the cluster that is reachable, doesn't give any certificate errors. So that's a good start. In this video, I'll create a new VM. I did it already, and I'll add that as a subscriber. So the clustering in ClearPass will work with publisher subscriber. Publisher is the first node in a cluster, and you do all the configuration on that node, and then you can just add subscribers to add a capacity, to add redundancy, high availability. You can use it to do geographic spreading. And as you can see, you can also make a virtual IP. So if the appliances are in the same IP subnet, you can use a VRIP address, which will be available on one of the appliances. What we will be doing is a virtual IP that's available at S.10 on the publisher, and it can fill over to the subscriber, and the subscriber will create a virtual IP with .9, which can fill over the other way. So here's my appliance that I created, the 10.11, and I already span up a new appliance. Let me see if I can reach that. So this one is for the subscriber. There's a certificate warning, which is expected because we have a brand new appliance here. So we can here change it. You can see it's a self-signed certificate. Let's accept and ignore. And we need to enter another license key. Remember that there is a platform activation key per VM. The access license, onboard license, on-guard license, these are shared across the cluster. Now we can sign in here, admin, and the password that we set during the installation of the VM. So this appliance is exactly the same. However, here it's the host name, cpm1sub, and IP address .12, where here we have the 11 and the pub. From this point, we go under administration, where we can make the appliance a subscriber. So here we can select make subscriber under server configuration. We need to enter the publisher IP and we need to enter the publisher password. Now we press proceed. It will show the root certificate that signed the HPS certificate that is on the publisher, that it detected on the publisher. And this is why I preferred to get the HPS certificate installed before we built the cluster. And with this, we can allow this certificate to be trusted and we can proceed with the subscriber operation. This will now run for roughly 4 or 5 minutes. And at this point, the configuration will be synced. This will be joined into the cluster. And I don't want to let you wait for that long, so I will speed up the video for now. You can see the subscriber was complete, so that wasn't that hard. We need to re-log in after some time. So let's see if it's ready already. Now you can see we have limited access, which is because this is the subscriber. And we can also see there is no link yet with the publisher, so the publisher is red. If we check the same on the publisher, let's refresh this page. You can see it's similar. So it will take another few minutes and then this will stabilize. And if everything is good, then the status will be green. So I'll speed up the video again. So both are green here on the subscriber. Let's check. Need to sign in again. We can see both are green as well. So probably this is the last time that I will sign into the subscriber, because you don't need to access the subscriber in most cases. You can do everything from the publisher. Few things that we need to do now. So first of all is we need to fix the certificate. We can do that from the publisher. So here under the certificate store, we can select now our subscriber. We can check the HTTPS certificate. Let's first disable the ECC certificate like we did on the publisher. And now we can install the RSA certificate. So let's import. And we can see the certificate now is installed. Because this is a wildcard certificate, so it's everything.lab.airheads.eu. It will also match the subscriber name. So this one should be good now as well. you can see now that the certificate, it is verified. The next step what we will do is we will set up the virtual IPs for the redundancy. Now before that, let's do another thing that I almost forgot, and that's the network access. So we did restrict access for the policy manager on the other node, and we need to do that here as well. So this will prevent devices that are not in these subnets to access the web UI. Now it's time to create the virtual IPs. To do that, we go here to the virtual IP settings under the server configuration, and we can type the virtual IP. So we will have a primary virtual IP, the IP address 10.10. We select the primary node. So this should be active on the publisher first, then on the subscriber secondly. Let's create that. And immediately let's create another virtual IP, which is available on the subscriber primary and then on the publisher secondary. Why do we do this? This is so we can put in the network devices primary nodes first, the primary VIP first. As a backup, we can use the .9 as the secondary, and the secondary VIP will be available on the subscriber and the primary on the publisher. If one of the nodes fails for some reason, both IP addresses will be on the same box. This will also help in the rare case that there is another issue in the ClearPass appliance where there is no failover for the virtual IP, then you will have the backup mechanism as built into the switches. You can see now both VIPs are available and green. It took a few seconds to do that. And let's have a look if we now can access it. So it should be CPPM. You can see we are there. This is the publisher now that we are accessing. You can check that by signing in. And we should be able to sign in to the .9 as well. But I'll leave that as an exercise for you at home. One thing, this virtual IP works great in many locations and in many sites where you have the ClearPass service in the same IP subnet. There are some more advanced scenarios where it makes sense to have a load balancer, like a network load balancer, in your network and use it to load balance the requests over different ClearPass servers that might be in different subnets. There's a nice tech note on how to deploy ClearPass with load balancers on arubanetworks.com/clearpassdocs. In this video, we created a cluster. Now we have a cluster with a publisher and a subscriber. We created two virtual IPs. That means that we are ready to rock. And in the next video, let's create a wireless LAN and connect that to the ClearPass server and make sure that we can authenticate clients on that wireless LAN. So looking forward to do that. I hope you like this video. If so, press the like button. Also subscribe to the channel, and then you will be notified when we have that WLAN video. If you have any questions or comments, put them under the video, and that will help us to make these videos even better. Thanks for watching, and till next time.